Similarly, the whole material world or any world, spiritual world, they are manifestation of the supreme energetic. The energies are coming. Energy, you have got also energy, I have got my energy. You cut your hair, automatically the hair will again grow. Do you know what is that energy? But there is energy, otherwise. A dead man, saved, will not grow. Will not grow anymore here. Finished. But a living man, because he has got that energy, so today you save, again tomorrow he will save. This is called inconceivable energy. Even I do not know what is that energy, you do not know what is that energy. We can talk foolishly, some bombastic words, these cells, this and that and so many things, but it is not in our control. So these two energies, material energy and the spiritual energy, one is superior and one is inferior, they are working within this world, mixture. And the spiritual world means there is no material energy, simply spiritual energy. There is no material energy. Everything is spiritual energy. There is no material body. There is no the bhumi, the land in the spiritual world is not land like this land. Chintamani prakara sadma su kalpa vrikhala khabriti su suravi ravipalayantam lakshmi sahasra sata samrama sebhumanam Govindam Adipurusam Tama, the Brahma Sangita. This is the description of the spiritual world. Chintamani Prakara Sadmasu. There are also buildings. But that building is not like this building, bricks and stone. Chintamani, touch a stone. Chintamani Prakara. Prakara means houses. Sadmasu, Kalpa. There are also trees. But those trees are spiritual trees. How? The kalpa vrikha. Here go to a mango tree, you get mango. But there to go any tree, you ask for mango or any fruit or anything, it will be supplied. That we cannot imagine. That how one tree can supply everything. Yes, that can. Because they are spiritual. Spiritual, just like my disciple, if I say, bring mango. So, you'll go anywhere and bring mango. Because he is spirit soul, living. But if I ask this pillow, bring mango, it will not be possible. That is the distinction between material and spiritual. And this fool is there trying to prepare spiritual energy by combination of material energy. They see their foolishness. They are trying to create living force by chemical combination. So, therefore sometimes we say, I do not say, Krishna said, a mura, rascals. This is not possible. You cannot manufacture life by combination of material, chemical. That is not possible. Here it is said that apara, the material ingredients, chemical is also material ingredients. You cannot produce. It is a different thing. Jiva-bhutang-mahāva. How it is superior? Jaya dhārjati jagat. Because this spiritual energy is there, therefore this world is important. Otherwise it has no value. In Africa, because the Europeans or Indians, they came here, they are spiritual energy. The Africans also spiritual energy. This is an example. But the advanced nation, they know how to utilize things, the matter. Therefore it is superior. The spiritual energy, living soul, knows how to utilize this matter. Jaya idam dharjachi jagat. Jagat, this world is made of material energy. But the spiritual energy, the living entity, he knows how to utilize this material energy. He knows how to utilize earth by making brick and making lime, and then they can construct a nice house. The controller is the spiritual energy. Therefore it is called param, superior energy. This is also energy. But these so-called scientists, they are making material energy and spiritual energy the same. They have no brain to distinguish. Here we have to understand from Krishna. Therefore Krishna's instruction is so important. If we don't take Krishna's instruction, then in spite of our so-called higher advancement of education, we remain simply mura, rascal. Rascal. Mura means rascal. Namāna duṣkita nam mūrha prapadyante narādhamā. Those who are not aware of the spiritual energy and the material energy, they are called mūrhas. Then if you understand what is spiritual energy, then you will search out there where from these, both of the Krishna says, both of them are coming from me. But if you understand the superior energy, spiritual energy, then it will be possible to understand what is Krishna. Krishna is a full spiritual energy, Satchidananda Vigraha. Ishara Parama Krishna Satchidananda Vigraha. Anadi Radi Govinda Sarva Karana Karana. So this is the first education to enter into the spiritual understanding. Krishna has begun from the very beginning, in the second chapter, that the spiritual energy is within this body. Dehinasmin tatha dehi kaumara jovanam jara tatha dehantara prapti dhirastatva namayati. So, there are many evidences in the Vedic literature that the spiritual energy is different from the material energy, and if you understand a spiritual energy, then you can understand what is God. Because spiritual energy is the sample of God. Sample of God. Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita that mamai vāṅsa. Here it is said jīva-bhūta. What is the jīva-bhūta? The jīva-bhūta, the living entity, mama eva-aṅsa, that my part and parcel.